So as you can see, we now have the outlines completed for both our black and gray and our color pieces that we're about to be doing. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start and complete the black and gray piece. Okay, so like I was saying before, when you're doing a piece that's black and gray, that's going to be completely black and gray with no color in it whatsoever, you want to basically utilize the negative skin, which would be the empty solid spots. I'm sorry, the empty spots that aren't solid and don't have any kind of shading in them whatsoever. Those skin tone areas are going to be used as a highlight. So basically you want to utilize that to where it would almost kind of accent the dark spots. So you'd use it as almost what would be a color. If it would say, if you were using white, that would be your highlight color. But being that it's going to be strictly black and gray, you want to use as little as possible, but you want to use it very specifically. So when you do your shading, you want to bring it out and leave just enough of there, just enough of skin tone left so it'll act like a highlight. And it'll still be have a nice full transition of black and gray shading in it. So in order to do that, again, what I was saying before is you use my particular type of shading. I'll break it down into three passes where I do a solid black that's broken down just slightly, just enough to give a little bit of transition. And then that's going to be faded into a medium shade, which is broken down about half and half, half ink, half water. And then that's shaded out a little further. And then I break it down one last time with just about maybe 10% ink and the rest water, which is very, very runny, diluted black ink. And that, what that'll do is it'll give me that last little bit of shading I did with a medium shade, with a medium black, and just wash it out and give me a nice, fine, smooth, very soft transition into that little light, little bit of negative skin left over from my highlight source. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and start with that very dark shading in my heavy shadow areas. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the upper right part here with the tip of the wing, and then I'm gonna work my way into it. Now, being that each row of wings, I don't have a whole lot of space I'm going to be working with, so I want to keep each pass relatively simple, okay? I don't want to fill in too much area because you have to think, you have three different shades of black and then your highlight, your negative skin source. So basically, there's going to be four different values of gray shading inside that little bit area. So when I do my initial pass with the solid black, keep it very, very light, simple, and basic. So basically I'm going to be working with just the tips, and as you can see I'm using a mag shader, which is relatively wide, so I'm going to be utilizing just the tip, just the pass, just the edge, like maybe say like the last three or four needles in there. And that's it, that's about all you're going to need to fill that in right there, just the tip of it. And also, as you can see, as I'm shading this in, I do a very light pass initially, wipe it off, see what I have, and then I'll add a little bit more as necessary. Usually it takes, you know, one or two passes and you'll get a good solid idea of exactly how much you're going to need. It's better to go too light and then build it up as necessary than to go too heavy the first time, because you can't lighten anything up once it's already there. So just very precisely, specifically, and gradually just build up a little bit of black right at the tip, with the tip of the needle. And you're also gonna notice what I referenced before, about utilizing a very, very light line work on certain areas where I don't want it to be too defined, because the majority of the definition is going to be built up with the shading. So as you can see, each pass I do, that line work that I had there initially is going to gradually start to fade away, to the point where all that remains is just a little bit of light shading to define the actual edge of each feather.